Is somebody hearing me?
Yes,
the same beauty you think you carry, your mother carried it before, is because of you. The 8 children, 7 children, 10, even my mother had 10 children. Until we tell her it's okay. Praise God. No support. No support. But yeah, when you have 3 children, they support you. Am I right? God, we bless our women. Put your hand together for Jesus. That's another word. But I have a message for you today. It's King David dance. I am not meant to dance for you. The singers are not meant to dance for you. They can only sing for you to dance. There is packages attached to it. Healings, expansion. It may be you have been depending God for the fruit of the womb. The moment you dance, God will expand you. Maybe you have been depending God for money, for expansion, your businesses. It's going to be really not through prayer, but through praise in the dance. Tell them to pray in the dance.
Pray in the dance.
I want you to know some things. What made King David to be a warrior who fought a war and won without sustaining an injury? I told him yesterday he was operating with the spirit of the might. I told the church yesterday in the book of Isaiah chapter 11 verse 2 that we have 7 spirits, the fear of the Lord, the spirit of wisdom and counsel, knowledge and fear of understanding, fear of the Lord. This 7 spirit made up what is called an anointing. When a man is anointed, this 7 spirit is in that man. But among the 7 spirits, it seems that interconnected with wisdom. Only one that is accepted. And that one is called the spirit of might. It's not connected with anything to do with wisdom. Praise God. And this is what David displayed in 2 places that made David to be a man after God's heart. He does with all his might. What does that mean? He does without reservation. He does with all his heart. If you study 2 Chronicles chapter 29, 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 2, he gave with all his might. Praise God. If you study Psalm 119, verse 164, he says, 7 times a day we have praise your Lord because of your righteous judgment. He was a king, he was a warrior. He was putting all his might to praise God 7 times in a day. Praise God. That means he did it or he put all his might. What is the spirit of might? Before you know, we have been hearing that it's done by man, it's not by man, it's done by power, but it's by the spirit. Am I right? Have you heard that song?
Yeah.
Have you heard that? No man shall prevail, by strength shall no man prevail. He's talking of strength. I want to tell you, until you become a fool for God, God never use you. Until you become a fool, God never work miracle to you and through you. One of my sons went to Bambek. Brother, you see, you had it. I said, I have told you, I'm not to service for power because I am not called to stay in a church. I'm a kingdom minister. That's what a kingdom minister.
Kingdom minister.
The difference between kingdom and the church. The church is for one. Kingdom is expansion. You go out. Praise God. What am I saying? Taking care of the windows. Taking care of the orphans. These are kingdoms. Praise God. Evangelizing. I am not called to stay in the church. After they said it, you had the power of God that moved in servant. I was told. I'm not surprised. Because those who kill into the anointing of this church, they must surely operate even greater than my own. And the children born here or the children brought up here, they are going to be more than any minister you can think of. Amen. Put your hand together if you can move. Because the impartation is coming all the time. We are anointing them all the time. When we talk of spirit of mind, it doing something without putting your own natural sense. When you are dancing with all your heart. People are looking at the type of dress you put on. Look, listen. We have heard that song, it's not my mind. Listen, I told the church yesterday, spirit of the Lord is called the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Is somebody with me? Spirit of the Lord will not make you know to commit fornication or adultery. Spirit of the Lord will not make you know to commit sins. It's the fear of the Lord that will make you know to commit sins. You want to steal because you have your anointed, don't mean you will not steal. Even most anointed people are stealing God's money. Praise God. Pastors, ministers of all kinds, they are committing immoralities. They are anointed. Anointing don't prevent you not to commit sins. It's the fear of the Lord. I told them we have two categories. The baby categories is what will people say. But another, when you develop what will God say. Because when you are in Jamaica, as I said yesterday, or when you are in America, nobody that knows you that is there. It's only God. But what will God say? Praise God. Until you are having this fear, what will God say? Until you come to this, you not what man says. You can even say, no, me, they call me. They are not my father. They are not anything. They are not my. They are not my God. But what will God say? But David, I want to tell you the difference between minds operating the spirit of mind, because we always concentrate on the spirit. On the spirit, spirit will not make you to come and be reading. You are the one to stand up to say, I want to read. As you are studying, then the spirit will not help you to understand it. And it wants you to study that the spirit of God will not bring it to your remembrance. That's somebody I hear. You want to slap your wife, the spirit of God will not hold your hand. You are planning in your heart. Praise God. You are just executing what is your heart. Says the money I hear. It is the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is called holiness. Says the money, holiness. It is one that makes you to say, oh, if not God, if not God, praise God. You want to speak evil against person, you want to manipulate lies against somebody for you to get support. No, I cannot do this. People call you for false witnesses. You say, I will do it. I will support you, my friend. Because you are still in a meek level. When you are in a meek level, you will say, I can't do that. Praise God. Yes, David danced with all his mind. What does that mean? He put all his energy. This dance, I call it the foolish of the spirit. And I call it the spirit of the foolish, which is the spirit of mind. What does that mean? Anything you are doing, you don't care what they say. What I mean, you don't care if somebody help you. You want to clean the church. They say 3 o'clock. You are only the one there. You are the one doing it. Let the other people think they are very clever. I'm coming at 5 o'clock when everybody will be finished. Praise God. The spirit of mind is the spirit that makes you to be a fool before God, and God will make you a mighty man. When you become, when you serve God with all your might, God will become almighty in your life. Is somebody hearing me? Yes, I want to tell you, why are we dancing to the Lord today? This is not the dance you are dancing. You are thinking, oh, which tailor saw this cloth when this sister put on? Or which shoe? Where did it buy? Is it from Brazil or from Italy? Or is it from Napoli market? Praise God. He said, it's the dance you are dancing to put your enemy to shame. It is dance of victory. Today is the middle celebration. Is somebody hearing me? You want to dance to celebrate God. Let me tell you what he said. If you study where we take the scripture, the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6 verse 14. He said, and David danced before the Lord with all his might. 2 Samuel chapter 6. Verse 14. And David danced before the Lord. Before the Lord. Not before man. Before who? Before the Lord. So when you are dancing, you are not dancing before the pastor. You are not dancing before any person. You are dancing before the Lord. And the Lord will come down to answer you. Why was David dancing before the Lord? Because he knew that God gave him rest in all area of life. Praise God. He fought a war. He fought a nation called Philistines. He fought a president in his own country called King Saul, the first king, and he defeated him. He said, I want to celebrate. Maybe that is battle God has given you victory. Maybe that is battle you are still in today. I want to tell you, because the presence of God is here, when you celebrate God, God God will finish it for you. That God will begin a good work, he will bring it to a perfect end. That God will bring you to that marriage, he will bless that marriage with children. That God will bring you to a journey, he will give you a residential permit to stay in journey. If God does not want you to be here, if God does not want to give you a permit to stay here, you will not be here. There are many people stuck on the way. There is a purpose of God bringing you here. May you discover that purpose in the name of Jesus. Amen. Is somebody hearing me? You will not fail God. Tell somebody I will not fail God. I am hearing a visa is released. Yes, God. That is what I am hearing. A visa is released. It will be of any of your relatives who want to come here, but a visa is released. Put your hand together for Jesus. Let me just tell you what will happen now. When David was dancing, his wife called him and said, you were dancing, you were trying your upright. What happened? Before the young guests, you were doing this. You king. He told Mika. And I said, Mika, I am not dancing before any man. I am dancing before the Lord, who chose me before your father, and who has made me a ruler over the great nation of Israel. Praise God. If you know God has made you a ruler over that situation, you should be ready to dance. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
That persecution, that affliction, God has made you to bear, God has made you overcomer. You will celebrate in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, I will not dance. Look at 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 1. When you praise God, I want to tell you, when you praise God today, what is going to happen? God will give you all round rest.
Amen.
Number one, what?
All round
rest. Because I want to tell you so that you know how to dance. All round rest. Do you know what all round rest? God will bless you in all every area. Amen. Finances, your home, everything you need.
Yes.
It will be blessed.
Amen.
All round rest. Tell somebody all round rest.
All round rest.
Number two, tell somebody number two.
Number
when you praise God in the dance, number two things that will strike you and that will happen to you and your sibling and your family and all the viewer, look at it. God will do wonders. That's what he wonders.
Wonders.
He said, who is like unto thee among thy gods? Who is like unto